I am really over this hair. Hey guys, so I just wanted to ask your opinion. This is my hair after having just blow dried it. I haven't curled it yet, and I know I've got some grays I really need to touch up. But my question is, should I cut it? And I have been going back and forth about this. I really want to cut it. I mentioned this in another video that in January I tend to just get it chopped. I'm not talking pixie cut or anything, I'm just talking like maybe up to here, which I've done in the past. I just feel like the older I get, the better I look with short hair. So anyway, yeah, I just wanted to know your opinion. I'm also going into our basement, one of our storage rooms. I've just had the itch to declutter and organize. I tend to do that every January too. I'm sure I'm not alone in that. I think a lot of people tend to organize and declutter and everything after Christmas. That's what I'm gonna do. I will check back in with you in a little while.
That's weird.
I just left the chiropractor. I'm sitting right in the parking lot. I go to the chiropractor once a month just to get an adjustment. I seem to really need it this month after Christmas, and my back was just more sore than usual. So I feel a lot better right now, and I'm trying to decide if I should go back home or if I should go to the store, because I don't have a whole lot of winter clothes that fit me very well. I've packed down a few pounds and I'm just tired of having clothes that just cling to me a little bit too much. So I'm not sure what I'm gonna do. I'll see which way I turn once I pull out of this parking lot, if I go left or right. It's so pretty out. I tried to take a little video on the way here. It did stop snowing, but there is still, there's so much snow everywhere. I just love it. I could live in Alaska, honestly. I really could. Noah ended up getting up early this morning and he shoveled the driveway and brushed off the car for me. I'm in Ethan's car today because we're going to be selling the van, hopefully. Brad recently waxed the van and so he didn't want me to drive it out in the snow, which is understandable, so I'm in Ethan's car today. So I will check back in with you all later.
Okay. We are in Massillon, Ohio to trade in our van, possibly. Hopefully we'll get a good deal. It's time to downsize. We don't need a van anymore. It has taken us many places. Both of our boys learned to drive in it. Twice we went to Disney World. Carpet, wood, all kinds of stuff we carried in this thing. It's just old and it's time for a change. After 15 years, I think we deserve it. Okay. Started at 18.4.
Lower. You should start lower than that.
I don't want to lowball and.
Yeah, okay. Then they're gonna go up.
Yeah.
gotta be smart about this. There's the one that we want, and they did not offer us the right price, so we said no. They offered us a good price, but we said no.
Yeah, ask Siri where Red Lobster is.
Okay, we're gonna go
or somewhere. We gotta go eat.
Stayed at Red Lobster, and now we're gonna be going to Walmart, even though it's 7:06. That's late by our standards.
That's late. Now we're gonna go dancing.
Yeah, right. January 13th, and we're on our way to the University of Akron. We're following our son Noah.
That's our boy up there.
This is his first day back after winter break, and he's got a lot of stuff, so we thought that we would go along with him. And what's he doing? What's that guy doing?
Didn't know what he's doing.
In other news, our van is sold.
Yeah, sold this morning. I put it on Craigslist yesterday afternoon. What? It must have been like 3 o'clock or 4 o'clock. And within an hour, I started getting messages, good pricing on it. It's very sentimental to us, but I'm not going to ask more money because it's sentimental to us. That's not what someone's paying for. Our sentimentality.
Our sentiment.
Whatever.
So we haven't replaced it yet, obviously. We're gonna see how long we can go without replacing it.
We'll see how it goes.
Yeah.
We no longer have a big hatchback, which comes in handy.
Yeah, I just said this morning, I said, it'd be really fun to go sledding. We haven't done that in a while. And he's like, we don't have the van anymore to put the sleds in. But yeah. They would fit in the car. I think the big one would, the big sled would fit in the car.
Yeah, put the back seat down and it would fit.
Yeah.
We just wouldn't be able to carry anybody in the back.
Yeah, we're about to get on the highway. Let me turn this and show you. I hope that we're in the picture. This is just a little, I don't know if this is a tip. We do use an iPhone 10. One thing that I didn't really know until Brad did some research on it, but the camera on the front of your phone is not as good quality as the one on the back of your phone. So if you were filming yourself with your camera, so that the viewfinder is facing you, which most is what most people do, the quality of the video is not as good as if you have it flipped around. I have it flipped around, so I have no idea what we look like in this viewfinder, if we're in the frame or not, but...
I know what you look like, but you're pretty cute.
Thank you. But the benefit of doing it like this is that, you know, not only do you get better quality, but also you are looking people in the eye when you're talking to them, which...
You're looking at the lens.
Yeah, you're looking in the lens, and therefore I'm looking you in the eye as I'm speaking to you and not looking over here. And especially if you have the phone just sitting in one place, like on a tripod, and you're not moving, it definitely makes sense to do it this way because you're going to be in the frame. You're not going to go out of the frame. Anyway, that's my little two cents. But I'll see. I'll see if this even comes out. Well, it has in the past. I've been doing it this way for a while. I'm still getting used to this phone, so I don't know. And also, there's two lenses on the iPhone XS, so I never know where to look. So I'm looking kind of like in the middle of both lenses. Anywho, we will check back in once we get to the University of Akron. Park in the parking garage, and this is a very bumpy road. for a month, he's probably sick of us. Just about to blow dry it. I am really over this hair. It's too long. I've gotten quite a bit done today. I'm determined to get all of my cleaning done that I have not done all week. Listening to some great music. What do you guys listen to when you're cleaning? I'm curious. Back cleaning in the boys' bathroom once again. I told you I'm determined to keep up with it this time, so there's hardly anything for me to scrub this time, which is awesome. I am really bummed because I cannot find my little gorilla pod that I like to use while I'm holding this. So if this is shaky, I apologize. I'm gonna find that thing so I'm not just holding my phone up for the rest of the day. I can't find that darn gorilla pod, so I'm using the gimbal now. It's gonna have to do. It's not like I really need a gimbal, but it's easier to hold the phone this way, so I'm gonna find out. It's just, I'm over here, Mr. Gimbal. Instead of dusting this really thoroughly, like with the Method wood spray and microfiber cloths and all that, I'm just gonna use my Swiffer duster. Put a brand new one on here. It smells really good. It smells like Febreze. And I'm just going to dust this room really fast. I'm not gonna record it though because I cannot find the darn tripod. So I think that's gonna do it for this week in the life. I have so much more to do today, but I think that I'm gonna go ahead and get this edited so that I can post it for you guys. I appreciate the fact that you took the time to watch this video. I always appreciate your comments and I love to read your comments and comment back. So please leave me a comment. I'm saying comment way too much. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you in the next one. Bye.